Hi, everybody. I'm Russ Mann from PermaShield. I've been brewing solutions on the Car Guy Coffee Podcast.
Let's brew!
That's what I'm talking about, Russ.
Come on, get you some.
So, good one, man. That was a great, that's a great example of what to do. Role play. And it works even when you get to the higher levels in sales and constant. I mean, what you're doing right now, you probably role play what you're going to say before you make a phone call, so on and so forth. You know what I mean? So, works.
Yeah.
It works.
When I grew up in the car business, when I first started in the car business, every single salesperson on the floor was like, you're an F&G. I don't know your name until you've been here at least 90 days. Thanks. Right? Yeah. I mean, that's the way it was, man.
I got a taste of that a little bit. Like when we came in, there were some people like that, but they hired a bunch of new ones. Like me and Lou kind of came in around the same time. We had this other guy named Johnny, this guy named Dave Harden. We were all like a year or 2 years in the business together, like right at the beginning. So we were just so hungry and we wanted to outdo these because we're like, we just got out of the military. Johnny did too. So we were already like, thought we were, you know, alpha male. Whoa. Because we could do push-ups and run and we served our time, which is a big deal. But we, you know, we did our thing, but we already felt that way. You know, we already had a lot of pride in ourselves, you know, in our, what we did. We already went through processes and understood how important a process is, you know, but we also understood that we had our own flavor. Each one of us felt like that we could do something, and we were the young ones, so we kind of joined up together, you know, and we had some mentors, but they didn't really give us tips, but it was more of us helping each other get better.
But we had other closers that we were trying to make sure that we were then validated with when we were saying, hey, we came up with this close. What do you think? Or we shut it down this way, or we're beating you. You know what I mean? Stuff like that helped. To help strengthen what it was that we were going through. But what was awesome is that when we started to build that together, we then 1,000% trusted another person with that deal. I know Fred's going to say what it is that I'm going to say. He's going to help get this handled, and he doesn't question for 2 seconds when I have that customer. As a matter of fact, we were both like, that one's done. I need to go find another one. You know what I mean? That's already handled. They got that. You know what I mean? There's nothing to question.
So that's what we do, man. That's great. That was a great tip, man. I think that's something no one's brought that up yet. That's perfect. I mean, you may have brought that up the last time we did something similar to that, but that was on the money, man. On the money. So here we go. You ready for this Car Guy confession session, my friend? I know. All right.
Here we go.
5, 4, 3, 2.
Car guys and car gals. Do you know what time it is?
I do.
It is that time again when we get together. To hit the deep parts, the funny parts, the seriously silly parts.
Might even be a little sad
parts. Our guests past. And we are here to enjoy with our friend, Russ Mann. A Car Guy Confession Session.
That's right.
Tell them about her.
Russ Mann, I know you got a story. You got a story for us. The people need to hear the story.
Yes.
I'm going to just go ahead and let you just tell it to them.
Get your popcorn, folks.
So I was selling cars. We had an offsite sale at the fairgrounds. It was like, this is a Peterson Motors. It was like 15, 20 miles away to the fairgrounds, but it was all by interstate. So we got done with the sale. Me and another guy named John and another guy named, his name was Voa. We hopped in these three cars. I was in a 3000 GT. I think Voa was in a Trans Am. These were used cars. It was a used car offsite sale. and John was in a 300Z, and we raced back, and it was so much fun. And when we raced back, well, about, I don't know, 2 or 3 hours later, each one of us got called into the GM's office, and I'm like, why is John and Boa going to the GM's office? I'm like, hey. and then I see them, they leave the office and they go off and do their thing, and they go and they come to me, and I'm like, Russ, we had this, there's two cars, and I know you were driving cars back with John and Boa. One was a Trans Am and one was a 300Z. But do you know, were they racing? They didn't see me. They didn't know I was with them. And I bus rolled them. And I said, yep, they sure were. Yep. I don't know nothing about it. And then, yeah. So about 15 minutes later, I saw them getting in their demos and leaving for the day. They got suspended, and I felt horrible about it ever since. But it was, you know, it was getting close to the end of the month. Those are the two top competitors that I had. Right? You know, we're all top three on the board, and wow, they got to go home, and good old Russ, you know, just a little. Oh yeah, I heard about that too, boss. I know exactly what you're talking about. No one ever asked me, were you racing with them? So it wasn't like I didn't tell them or not. I just, yeah, that's what I heard. Yeah, I think so. Because they only thought the Trans Am and the 300, right? Because I was so far in front of them, they didn't see me. I mean, they weren't even in the rear view because we were in traffic. I mean, this is Monday morning. Like, yeah. We arrive at the dealership at 8 o'clock. We hop in a van. We all go to the, you know. And yeah, so hopefully they'll see it and they'll understand. But those guys have done things to me that I don't feel that bad either.
It is what it is. Bygones. It's a great story because all of us have been through something like that. Because the cool thing is that they were true brothers and they didn't tell on you. Right. You know what I mean?
Yes.
They just took the licks and said, you know what? We're not going to tell. You know, that's what bros do. Even though it's competitive, you still don't do it. That's period.com, right. No one tells, right? But you definitely don't rat yourself out. I'm not going to do it. Hey, did you hear about the racing? What racing? Man,
what?
Those guys tell are crazy. Me. You should probably send them home for the rest of the week. Oh.
Did anybody get hurt? Oh, wow. What happened? Oh, wow.
Man.
Yes.
Man, do you need me to work that deal?
Yeah, I'll take care of their deals when they come in. Yeah, folks, I got you.
Don't worry about it, guys.
You guys just enjoy your time off. Well, folks, that right there was a car guy confession session.
With Russ Mann, we've had such a great time. I really don't want this to end, and I know that it's not going to end. We have so many more brews that we're going to do again with you in the future.
I'm sure.
But I want you to know that all in all, I mean, camera rolling, camera not rolling, we are grateful for the relationship that we've had the opportunity to brew inside of the cafe and in social media land. Yep. And look forward to brewing more solutions and helping more people in the process. Because again, we want to make sure that we are teaming up with true solutionaries that are finding ways to help people with a problem and actually bring value to their life, which is what you get up daily to do. And I want to tell you, we honor that as a team. And we definitely are with you. And we want to make sure that everybody knows that you need PermaShield inside of your tire.
You're crazy if you ain't got it yet. I guess I'm crazy because I'm getting it, though.
Crazy.
So, crazy. Russ, I also want to thank you, man. That's it. No flats guarantee. Folks, it's beyond the product. If you need something, just get a hold of Russ.
Yes.
Russ can point you to the right people. But most important, if you do need those tires, just give him a holler, man. He will make sure your tires are set up for good and you will not have any flats. And just become friends with this guy. I know I've just become friends with him, and I feel like that my life has gotten that much better because of that. So thank you very much for your time, Russ.
Likely to.
Yeah, I'll tell you, I got two things. One, thank you for your time. The energy and effort. I mean, you guys have regular full-time car dealership jobs. Right. So the time and effort that you put into not only doing, you know, this hour and a half with me, but the time to edit them, the time to post them, the time, all those things that takes to push out a final product. I'm absolutely grateful for. It makes a difference in my life. It'll make a difference in my company's life, and I appreciate that very much. And then two is your service. I do know that both of you are in the Army and the Air Force, and I'm absolutely grateful for the things that you and others before you have sacrificed and their families have sacrificed so that I can stand here on this camera and have this conversation with you. That's the part that's the most important thing to me. Your things that you've done in your life created the freedom for me and others to do the things that we do, and I'm absolutely grateful for that.
And I appreciate that. You know, words like that are what make people do what we did. You know what I mean? It's, they do it for the country, but there's nothing better than hearing other people give you a little love for that. You know, when you, there's, I always, when I see somebody in a uniform, I always want to give them, I always give them an extra head nod or something. You know, if I can't combo with them, we're just walking by, I'm always going to give them that, I know who you are and what you're doing. Look, you know what I mean? So
right. For those of you that don't know, we're just coming out of the season where this is being recorded. We are just celebrating Memorial Day weekend.
That's right.
And those that have paid the ultimate sacrifice for us each to have our freedoms. Is something we cannot articulate clear enough, the honor that we have to give it the magnitude or the bigness that is to us.
It's impossible. You know,
we're thankful for it.
It's absolutely impossible to show enough gratitude.
Absolutely. Right.
I agree with that.
But I am determined to never stop.
Showing gratitude. That's right. Yes. You know, and I appreciate you, Russ. We appreciate what you're doing. Thank you for coming on the show for part dos. Bro, we'll talk some more soon.
It is Russ Mann, folks. He is leaving the building. The podcast.
Bye. We appreciate it. We'll see y'all later. Y'all tune in. You tune in to Car Guy Coffee.
Let's brew. Some of that.
Boom.